Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats. The show is about to begin. Before it does, two public announcements. Firstly, out of consideration for your fellow patrons, please turn off your cell phones. And secondly, if you're one of those, "I love Pink Floyd, but I can't stand Roger's politics" people, you might do well to fuck off to the bar. Just the basic facts. Can you show me where it hurts? There is no pain you are receiving. A distant ship smoke on the horizon. You are only coming through in waves. Thank you.
okay. Just a little pinprick. There'll be no more. But you feel a little sick. Can you stand up? I do believe it's working. Good. That'll keep you going through the show.
There is no pain you are receiving. A distant ship smoke on the horizon. You're only coming through in waves. Your lips move, but I can't hear what you say. Out of the
powers of thee, the powers of thee, the powers of thee, the powers of thee, the powers of thee, the powers of thee, the powers of thee, the powers of thee, the powers of thee, the powers of thee, the powers of thee, the powers of thee.
They're like a tough game, you don't lose, some you win, some you lose. Competition got for you. The diamond to be free. Yeah, the powers of be,
the powers of be, the powers of be, the powers of be.
They're like a bomb-proof Cadillac, air-conditioned gold tap, back seat, gun rack, grab a cat. They've been courses for courses, they're the pocket horses.
They're like order, makeup, dynamite power, game shows, rodeos, Star Wars TV.
They're the powers of be, if you see them coming,
you better run. Run. You better run. You better run.
You better run.
Run. You better run.
Some pundits said our programs would result in catastrophe. Our views on foreign affairs would cause war.
Once you begin a great movement, there's no telling where it'll end. We meant to change a nation, and instead, we changed a world.
Thank you.
2 years later, another economic summit, pretty much the same cast. At the big opening meeting, we all got together, and all of a sudden, just for a moment, I saw that everyone was just sitting there looking at me. And then one of them broke the silence. "Tell us about the American miracle," he said.
"Hey, Martin, over here. Two more shots and two more beers. Sir, turn up the TV sound. The war started on the ground. Just love those things, kind of bonds. They're really great for right and wrongs. You'll hit the target when they came from Mars, 3,000 miles away. 3,000 miles away. They play the game with the bravery of being out of range.
You gotta hydrate. Speaking of bars, hey bartender, you know what I'm gonna do before I tell you about the bar and bartenders and all of that? I'm gonna say welcome. It's really lovely to be here in Columbus, Ohio. I'm so glad you could all come. It's been 2 years. I think we should have been here 2 years ago. Was this on the tour 2 years ago when we booked the tour? Don't seem very sure. Well, if it was on the tour 2 years ago and anybody bought a ticket and they hung on to it and they're here tonight, thank you, brother or sister, wherever you might be. Okay, we're going to do a little bit of a song that I wrote during the COVID lockdown, and it is called The Bar. And the bar is a place in my head. It's an imaginary place, but it's also a real place. There are bars all over the world. In my head, it's a place where you can go and maybe have a drink, but certainly meet your friends, and hopefully meet strangers as well, and you can exchange opinions with strangers and with friends, with no fear or favor, and it's somewhere where you are welcome, where you can exchange your love for your fellow man without fear, one to another. So just for tonight in Columbus, Ohio, this is the middle of the bar where this piano is, and you are all in the bar, and we are doing just that tonight. We're exchanging feelings with one another, and it gives me great pleasure. Okay. So, this is a very long song, so I'm only going to do a tiny little bit of it, a couple of verses. There are two characters towards the end of this little bit of the song, and they're two women. One of them is a homeless black lady who lives in a cardboard box somewhere with a dog called Lady, who is a chihuahua. This may not seem relevant, and it isn't. It's completely irrelevant, but I don't know. It's an embellishment. Anyway, and another lady, who is a young lady, who is a Lakota Sioux from Stanimac in North Dakota, who sees this lady and decides to crossover and help her, and she helps her by bringing her to the bar where we all look after her. So this is, those are two people in this bit. Here we go. Does everybody at the bar feel good? Yeah, sure, they do. Is everybody at the bar a little mad? Yeah, good. Okay. I'm so tired. What is wrong with me? Don't answer that. We'll be here all night if you start answering that question. If you don't know what's wrong with me, read the paper. Well, obviously, I love you too, or I wouldn't be here, would I? Whoever you are. Thank you. Thank you, beautiful. Okay. We're going to drift back through the mists of time now, turn back the clock a bit, and travel back to an earlier age when I was playing in a different band.
Thank you.
So, so you can tell.
Heaven from hell,
blue skies from
pain.
Can you tell a good feel
from a coast you hear?
Thank you.
Thank you. your rear tonight. This is for you. It's called Rock Like Hell.
Thank you.
satisfied with God. I would have rearranged the veins in the face to make them more resistant to alcohol and less prone to aging.
our help.
Becomes the president. Every time a
searching for its keys. And every time the green man crawls in the fucking seat, it's because all of us, the blacks and whites, Chicago's Asians, every tongue of ethnic groups, even folks from Guadeloupe, the old and the young, toothless hags, supermodels, actors, rags, leading on, football stars, men in bars, washerwomen, tailors, tights, grandmas, grandpas, uncles, aunts, friends, relations, hopeless traps, clerics, chuckles,
cleaning ladies,
ants, maybe not ants. Well, because it's true,
the ants don't have enough IQ to differentiate between the pain
the other people feel. Well, for instance, hitting knees or crawling across the nose in search of open trickle tears. So like the ants, are we just dumb? Is that why we don't feel or see?
Or are we all just dumb now on reality TV?
We show every time.
The curtain falls.
Thank you.
progress. Oh, it is on my progress. Remembering games, days of chains and rocks. Got to keep the Lord is on the path. The Lord is in my heart. The Lord are in my heart. The paper holds their folded faces to the floor. And every day the paper board brings more. Someone in my head, but it's not me.
Wow, thank you. Let me try that again.
Thank you!
I shouldn't speak too much more like that, because we're doing a couple of more songs. But I feel like it, because you've been such a lovely audience, and we've had such a fucking great time, and you've given us so much love and welcome here, that I feel like shouting my head off. You know what, I don't know if you've noticed that the top bit of this building is almost completely empty, except maybe, I don't know, who they are, there's a few people up there. Because we've pulled the people from the top down, so that it looked fuller than it actually is. So I'm going to say something really silly now, but I just thought of it like a minute ago, and it is, so the obvious fact is, we didn't sell out, but we didn't sell out, if you see what I mean. I just wrote that. And we never will sell out, either. We will, however much they cut up my interviews on CNN to make me look like a prick, I will not sell out. We will stand on our tiny platform of human rights. Forever. I know that, we didn't sell something. Alright, well, I'm going to stop crowing now because it's not becoming. What we're going to do, oh, I know. We're going to do a song off the last album that I made with Pink Floyd, which was called The Final Cut, and it was in 1982. So it's a while ago. It's the last track on the album. It's called Two Suns in the Sunset. And there is... Thank you, sir. We're sort of playing Simon Says, or something like that. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh yeah, it's Two Suns and the Sunset is a somewhat gloomy tale of the nuclear catastrophe actually happening. And so there's this introduction to it, and that is in 1957, a committee of atomic scientists got together because they were really frightened about the proliferation of nuclear weapons. And they invented an idea, and their idea was called the Doomsday Clock. And in 1957, they said we were so close. And by the way, if the Doomsday Clock ever strikes midnight, that's it, we're all dead. Everybody dies. So it's quite an important clock. And in 1957, they set it at 20 minutes to midnight. That's how worried they were. And they were right too, because in 61, we all know the Cuban crisis. And since then, there have been many much closer shaves than the Cuba Missile Crisis. I won't go on about them because, anyway, because, well, anyway, let me finish. So, yeah, they met again this year. They meet every single year. And this year, they set their doomsday clock at 90 seconds to midnight. So I think it's right to play this song tonight. So I can hear the doomsday clock ticking behind me. So here we go, and thank you again. Thank you so much. Thank you. hold it, stop. I fucked that up. I'd much rather start in time with the film and for it to be. I started on a G instead of a D major. It's because I was overwhelmed by your reception for it, I think. And part of me that should have been putting these three fingers down here, put my feelings here. But I'm not too proud to have made a mistake. Sorry, chaps. Chaps in the band. I'll do better this time. Also, I was wondering why I couldn't hear the doomsday clock, Mike. Because I couldn't. But anyway, just send me the count again, and I promise I'll try better.
Windshield melts and your tears evaporate. ashes and diamonds. Forward friends, we were all we were in the end.
Wow. Right, here we are. Here we are back at the bar. Finalmente. How cool. Cheers, man.
Cheers!
Right, we're going to do a little bit more of the bar. I have to, at the beginning of this, I have to apologize to Bob Dylan because I've stolen some of his lyrics. But whatever you do, don't tell him. I mean, I don't know how Bob is these days. I'm sure he's well. He's a sprightly old soul. And I just don't want him to sue me. Anyway, I'll tell you what it is that I've stolen. In 1966, he made a record called Blonde on Blonde. And the whole of side two is a wonderful song called Sad Eyed Lady of the Lowlands. And what I've stolen is the words Sad Eyed Lady and Big Brass Bed, which are both in the song. So thanks, Bob. So that's that out of the way. The Sad Eyed Lady that I sing about here is rarely sad eyed, but she is sad eyed sometimes because she has a big heart and she has a lot of empathy for her brothers and sisters all over the world who are less well off than she is. And that's my wife, Camila, who's not here today, but so this is dedicated to her as well. I think that's enough. I'll start. Shall I start? I think I should start. How many cannonballs is that a foghorn in the distance? Oh, we're heading for the run. Come sit here by the fireside and hold me in your arms. And tell me, how was life before the cops?
Thank you.